Galaxy S10 Lite is the phone that Samsung talked the most about before the S20's release. This phone apparently happens to be the Lite version of the S10, but it's got a few traits of Samsung's 2020 smartphones, especially when it comes to the cameras. The camera on the S10 Lite is one of the best in the sub-flagship segment, but is this phone's camera really worth all the hype? We will find that out in this video. If you are new here, it would be massively appreciated if you can subscribe to my channel. S10 Lite is equipped with three rear cameras. The main camera is a 48-megapixel Sony IMX 586 sensor. This is the same sensor that we saw on the OnePlus 7 series and many other popular phones. Next one is the 12-megapixel ultrawide camera, and then there is a 5-megapixel macro camera. On the front, the S10 Lite houses a single 32-megapixel Sony IMX 616 sensor. S10 Lite has the typical Samsung camera app. It welcomes you with the photo mode turned on. It is set to 3:4 mode by default, which means you need to switch it to 3:4H to capture 48-megapixel pictures. You also have to do the same to capture 32-megapixel selfies on this phone. After that, we get the live focus, the video mode, and almost all the modes like the slow-mo, super slow-mo, pro mode, the night mode and others. This phone can also capture slow-mo selfies. Pro mode here has only three options. You can change the white balance, the ISO, and the exposure only. A few more options would have been a bit better. This phone can capture 4K at 30 frames per second, 1080p at 60 frames per second from the rear camera. Same goes for the front camera as well. A very interesting option I found in this phone is the zoom in audio. You heard that right. And you can see it yourself too here. Like the flagship Galaxy Note 10, you can use some mic zoom in to record better audio. The rest of the features are as same as any other Samsung device. I have taken pictures on this phone in many different environments. Let's start off with the 32-megapixel selfies first of all. Now this phone is powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon 855 and displays a role in image processing as well. The 32-megapixel selfies are huge and they come out with immense details. Zooming in shows you how accurately this phone can take selfies. This is a group selfie versus an ordinary selfie from the front camera. The skin tone in the selfies has a cool tone, not very natural, but does not compromise a lot on the sharpness. The edge detection in the normal selfies is good, but in the live focus, it wipes off the edges. I think that is just normal for a portrait or a live focus picture. Low light selfies were quite surprising. I did not expect this phone to take such neat photos, but it did. The perks of this low light expert camera can be seen in this selfie. The selfie comes out as if there was a lot of light in the room, but in real, the light was close to zero. The noise is minimum. Extremely soft pictures once again. The night mode further improves the pictures. Moving on to the photos taken through the rear camera. Ultrawide versus the normal versus the live focus. First of all, check the color tone. This is the magic of the Sony IMX 586 sensor. I remember checking this sensor before in the OnePlus 7 phones and I was impressed with the color tone. The live focus nicely blurs out the background. Now there are two modes in this phone. One is the 48-megapixel and the other is a 12-megapixel normal mode. You are looking at 48-megapixel versus a 12-megapixel pictures now. Note it down. The 48-megapixel picture has very good details and that is because of the huge size of the pictures. But the 12-megapixel picture has better dynamic range and that is because the HDR does not work with the 48-megapixel mode. Color tone is the same on both the sides. Taking a look at more 48-megapixel versus 12-megapixel photos shows a similar results. You either have to compromise on the details or the dynamic range. Depending on what you are willing to sacrifice, choose your camera mode. The cool tone is sometimes too cool in some pictures. The phone does a nice overall job with the outdoor pictures. Of course, the edge detection is not at its best sometimes, but the shallow depth of field can be seen in the pictures too. The pictures do not lack the details entirely. In some pictures, you will see this phone making the shadows a bit too dark, but that, in my opinion, is just okay. You are now taking a look at the ultrawide, normal, and the zoomed in pictures. The ultrawide pictures have better dynamic range, but you will not get those details here. The normal pictures have slightly reduced dynamic range, but sharp and detailed images with a balance of colors. In the indoor pictures, this camera pretty much speaks for itself. I found all the colors accurate, even in the normal mode. An object placed too close gets all the attention while the background nicely blurs out. Now the night mode. As this phone has a pixel binning mechanism, it's supposed to take better low light pictures, and it does live up to the promise to some extent. The pictures do not have a lot of noise, and with the slightest amount of light, it can pretty much make everything visible in a picture. The details are intact. Of course, they will not be as good as the details of a daylight picture. In the end is the macro camera. Now this is some sort of an add-on. Having it on your phone will let you capture objects placed too close nicely. It is useful for teeny tiny objects too, and it is pretty much self-explanatory. I would loved having a telephoto lens instead, but Samsung has now included the macro camera and you got to use that. The videos now. S10 Lite shoots 4K at 30 frames per second. According to Samsung, this phone has dual optical image stabilization, which basically means that the cameras combined together can deliver better stability in the videos. The 4K footage comes out as expected. It is fine. This phone can take 4K footage in the ultra-wide camera mode too. It also has the 1080p at 60 frames per second, and it is really good to have this mode. Your videos will look buttery smooth in 60 frames per second. Although I am rendering this video in 30 frames per second, you can definitely imagine how good the 60fps footage will look in real. Take a look at the front camera videos now. This is the front camera's 4K video from the Samsung Galaxy S10 Lite. This phone can do 4K video at 30 frames per second from the front camera. And in this video, you can check out the colors being captured by this phone and also check out the mic quality. Furthermore, this phone can do 1080p at 60 frames per second, and I am going to show you that now. Now, this is the 1080p at 60 frames per second from the S10 Lite. I am very happy that this phone can shoot at 60 frames per second from the front and rear cameras, because this helps this phone set itself apart from the Samsung Galaxy A lineup. This also brings the S10 Lite a bit closer to the flagship devices. And this now brings us to the conclusion. The S10 Lite has a very good camera. Despite that 48 megapixels gimmick, it takes nice pictures. The color tone is very good. The addition of zoom in audio mic helps this phone get one step closer to the phones like the Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus. This is a feature that even the Note 10 Lite doesn't have. But Samsung has added it to the S10 Lite to increase its value. The Snapdragon 855 processes the pictures way better than the Exynos phones, and that is also a plus point of this phone. So we can safely say that the camera on the S10 Lite is the best for the phone of this category. But at the same time, it does not justify the price tag it comes with. You can get the exact same camera on the OnePlus 7 for a price a lot lower than this. But obviously, you cannot ignore the Samsung brand value here. Before you get your hands on the S10 Lite, I would suggest you to taking a look at the Note 10, the Note 10 Plus, the S10 and the S10 Plus's reduced prices on the Amazon, the eBay, and in your local market. Let me know about your thoughts in the comment section below. Also, drop your feedback about this video. If you have not subscribed yet, please subscribe now and press the bell icon. With that said, I will sign off. See you in the next one really soon.